just a guest name. And all of my rhymes do not give up. X games, guns turn three boys into pit, sex chain. And I smoke till I got chest pain. And you can just know I rep my game like Jesse James. Women are possessive, and they are possessed brain. I've been gone so long, I fell asleep on the hooker plane. Skinny pants and some fans. Call me Triple H, get my advance in advance. Amen, as the world spinning, dance in my hands. Life is a beach, I'm just playing in the sand. Wake up and smell them. Can't see me, but never overlook me. I'm on the paper trail, and ain't no telling where it took me. Yeah, and I ain't the killer, but don't push me.
Yeah. there was some measures in place for safety that kind of isolated students, and that wasn't the best situation for Zach. Believe it or not, socially, he struggled a little bit right then. But look at him now. He's killing it on campus. He's absolutely flying. But that's not the thing that I think, the development side of things, I can't speak enough about Zach, the amount of improvement academically and socially that you've grown throughout the years here. The major thing is empathy. You're one of the most empathetic students and players and people I've ever met. And I want to give you a little example of that. So I was stopped, and not a week goes by where I'm not stopped by somebody complimenting about Zach and what he's done around campus. But on one particular day, this one stood out. Passively, we always walk by people, and we'll say, how you doing? And everyone will say good, and we'll just keep walking back and forth. And that's just normal courtesy. But this particular student made a point to tell me, and she's been here much longer than me. She said, Damon, I gotta tell you something about your boys. Normally when I hear that sentence, I stop, and I'm like, what did they do? She said, no, not that. She said, I wanted to tell you about Zach Newman. He always asks me how I'm doing. I said, yeah, that's nice. But no, he said, he stops, and he waits. And he's one of the only students I've ever had that actually really wants to know how I'm doing. So Zach, for your empathetic behavior around campus, for your absolutely astonishing growth from grade 10 to now, I love you and I want to welcome you to basketball world, my friend. Look at that smile on him now. Hey, that wasn't there for grade 10. Beautiful. The next one goes by the name of Ben Big Ticket Power. Oddly enough, I first ran into Ben Power in the gymnasium at Rothesay High School. I was running an ECBA camp at the time, and in walks this strapping lad with socks up to above here, giant black goggles on, and it was Ben Power from Grand Bay, Westgate. And I knew nothing about Ben at the time, and you know, he ran a good camp, and you know, I believe he won Camp of the Day, or I believe he was an award winner of some sort. But truth be told, I didn't leave that camp being like, whoa, Ben Power, what an astonishing talent. He definitely was good. But, you know, years passed, and I have this online form that you can fill out if you want to be recruited by me, or you want to show me some game film. And one particular day, I wasn't necessarily contacting parents, so it kind of went to the wayside, but I noticed that Benjamin Power filled it out for Grand Bay. And I said, oh yeah, that's Ben Power. I remember Ben Power. And then I didn't return, you know, a message. I just was doing something else, and time passed. And then a few days went by, and it was filled out again. And then, again. And I was like, well, I think this kid really wants me to look at this film, so maybe I should check it out. So I clicked the link, and I was absolutely astonished. Well, first off, I was extremely disappointed that the socks and the goggles were gone. I wish they were still around. But Ben it was the U15 highlights for the Nationals, and he was an absolute stud. And I was just dumbfounded how much development has happened since the last time I saw him. Now, for most of you in the crowd, from that point to now, it's like a very fast-burning star that went out temporarily. So Ben tore his ACL in grade 10, as we know. He lost the rest of his grade 10 year after having a very promising start. He didn't play in grade 11, although the amount of buy-in that I saw, filming games that, you know, he knew he could help his team, and you could tell how frustrated he was just heartbreaking. And for any competitor, any parent of a competitor, any coach that has a competitive team, when you see a player like that unable to do their craft, it rips your heart out, and all you want to do is cry for them. And I'll be honest with you, if that happened to me in grade 10, that's a wrap for my career. Like, I would not have been able to do that. Not only did Ben Power rehab, get back to find form, have coaches interested, he actually got better. He got in better shape. He became more hungry. He invested more into his teammates. When it was just so easy just to show note, if you need a haircut, go to Steen's Barbershop on the west side. It's beautiful. And I got a phone call, and, you know, this person might be in the crowd. If you are, I really apologize, because I have no idea still who you were. I can't remember the name. But I believe they were from Fredericton, and they were going off about this kid, Owen Smith, from Harvey High School. And, you know, I think the beginning of the story, as you know, you got to know him, and if I fast track to the beginning a little bit, he ended up, we know him, okay? But it's after he got here that really, honestly, I don't know how much it changed him, but it changed me. Grade 10, as all of you are aware, was a complete, you know, dark time when it came to pandemic and what you could or couldn't. So for a grade 10 being new to the school, it was tough. Compound that with the fact that on that particular team that year, we had men. We had guys like Sam Elmutu, Mateo Ferrer, and Joshua Heber, and Matt Peddle, who were actually men. And a guy like Owen, who wasn't quite a man yet, really found it challenging to come into battle. And what we could do was we could go in bubbles and we could play one-on-one. And on a particular day, I was on duty, and when we were on duty, at that time, you couldn't go in the dorm room, so I had to have a conversation with Owen, and he wanted to talk to me, and we couldn't do it in the room, so we had to do it in the hallway. And I remember sitting in the hallway, and I had my mask on, he had his mask on, and he was going on about how frustrated he was, and I can't say what he labeled it, we will just call it the ice. He said he had the ice. Now, he called it by a different name, and it basically meant that he wasn't strong enough, he wasn't competitive enough, he never could win, and he wanted to get over this hump of being scared. And what started off as a 15 to 20 minute conversation quickly ballooned into a 2.5 hour conversation about anything but basketball. And that's honestly what you've been with me since that day. We've been connected at the end. No one on that bench would argue that in this gym, Owen Smith is the heartbreaker. He's the leader. We know that. And in a small little aside, Owen Smith also holds the role of being Ben Power's personal assistant. So it's a very important role. If anyone wants that role next year, please reach out to him. But truth be told, the conversations since that day that Owen and I have been life-changing for me. Owen, but you've made me a better coach. You've made me a better person, you've made me a better parent, just by the way you carry yourself, by the way you converse, and by how you're always open and willing to chat. So Owen, for everything you've done for me, and for obviously everything you've done for your teammates, I love you and I want to welcome you to basketball program.
Thank you.
That concludes our seniors. We've got 4-ish minutes. We're just going to allow the boys to warm up, and then we're going to get going. So thank you very much. Seniors, please come over here. Thank you.
I like to watch them. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.